Hello everyone, I'm Shavita Sharma Kukreja, Co-Managing Director, Central Square Foundation, and it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the education track at Charcha 2021. Charcha this year again has been set up in unprecedented times. Unfortunately, now we are at a stage where 250 million school-going children of our country have been out of school for more than a year and a half and counting. And the theme that we are bringing to Charcha is Build Back Better. We've all realized that the solution to education to correct for the impact of COVID will now need to be much more than remediation or just a simple catch-up program. What we will need is an integrated solution which corrects not just only for the forgotten and missed learning on the academic side, but also solves for the social, emotional, and mental well-being of all our children and the school community. Our topic for our keynote as we kick off our education track is schooling and learning through and beyond COVID. And this time for our keynote, not only do we have eminent sector leaders, but I'm very excited to include the voice of our most important stakeholders, our children. My co-panelists today actually don't need any introduction. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Rukmini Banerjee, CEO Pratham Education Foundation, and Vishal Talreja, co-founder Dream a Dream. Thank you both for making time for us. And also joining us are four children, Madhu, Kavya, Muskan, and Mahi from Delhi, Bangalore, and UP. And we will be hearing from them the challenges they have faced, what hopes they have, and what are their expectations from school, from education, and learning through these unprecedented times. With that, I'll hand over to Vishal to kick off the conversation.
Thank you, Shavita. I must say good afternoon, namaste, and namaskara. because we have young people today who speak English, Hindi, and Kannada, come from Bangalore, Delhi, and now in UP. And actually my work is really simple today. I have to step back and allow young people to bring their life stories, experiences, and their opinions to all of us. So I'm really happy to be here today. And I'm looking forward to listening to Muskan, Madhu, Kavya, and Mahi. Preparation for this panel has been very much like the reality of the last 1.5 years. As we were trying to get the young people online, young people were having internet issues, communication issues. I think one young person is still trying to join in. So that is the reality we are struggling with learning and education. But they are here now and they're eager to talk to all of us. And as Shavita pointed out, we hope to hear from them what have been some of their challenges through the last year. And what are some of their hopes and expectations from the future? So I'll hand it over to Rukmini, and then we can start the conversation with the young people. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Vishal. I think this is a very interesting way. I think pura probably iske baad education ke upar charcha hogi. But what better than to hear from the children themselves? And like Vishal said, ki अर्बन लोकेशन से कनेक्टिविटी थोड़ा ठीक से हुआ है. वी हैव बीन एबल टू कनेक्ट स्लाइटली बेटर फ्रॉम बैंगलोर एंड फ्रॉम दिल्ली. बट रूरल यूपी से एक हमारी लड़की है माही, जो जिसकी वॉइस पहुंच जाएगी हम तक, पर उसका वीडियो में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है. बट यही है, दिस इज द समस्या जो हम सबको फेस करना पड़ा था फॉर द लास्ट सो मेनी. सो इन अ वे आई थिंक दिस इज अ परफेक्ट लोकेशन बिकॉज वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम एग्जैक्टली वेयर वी वर. Vishal, I will hand it back to you because you are a much better moderator than I am. And let us see कि हम लोग आधे घंटे में, एक घंटे में हम लोग क्या-क्या बातचीत कर सकते हैं.
Sure, Rukmini. So, Mahi, Madhu, Muskan, and Kavya, welcome and thank you for joining us. शुक्रिया कि आप आज हमारे साथ जुड़ सके. एक छोटा सा पहले सवाल है कि आप अपना एक इंट्रोडक्शन दीजिए, नाम और कहाँ से आप फ़ोन कर रहे हैं या ऑनलाइन आए हैं, और आप जहाँ रहते हैं what do you like about the place? Where do you live? If you live in Bangalore, in a particular community, what do you like about where you live? So your name, where you're calling in from, and what do you like about the place you're calling from? So Muskan, you want to go first?
I hope you can hear me.
Yes, we can hear you.
All right. Hi everyone, I'm Muskan. I'm from Delhi. I'm a part of Slam Out Loud, which is an organization based in Delhi. I write poetry, I paint, and I'm currently studying in 12th grade in G.D. Goenka Public School. And one thing that I love about Delhi is that we get all kinds of food here. So I can just go anywhere and just get anything to eat.
Thank you, Muskan. Madhu, can you go unmute and tell us a bit about yourself and what you like about where you live?
My name is Madhushree, and I'm like to do to dancing, painting, and drawing, and eating.
And what do you like about where you live, Madhu?
I'm living in Bangalore.
Lovely. Thank you, Madhushree. Kavya, welcome. I'm glad to see you're back.
Yes,
so Kavya, just introduce yourself, what you're doing, and what do you like about where you live?
Hello everyone, myself, this is Kavyashree. I'm studying in second year PUC right now. I live in Bangalore. What I love the most in Bangalore is its popular city. And we have some freedom here, which we personally enjoy. So that's
it. Thank you, Kavya. And Mahi, I hope you're online and are able to hear us. Aap apna thoda ek introduction de denge, aur kahan se aap phone kar rahe hain? I think Mahi is trying to get online.
Yeah, Vishal.
Okay, we'll come back to Mahi when she comes back online.
Correct.
So Madhu, Kavya, and Muskan, the first question I have for you is, you know, you've been out of now school or college for a year and more. How has that experience been for you? What has been the impact of that experience for you in your life, for your learning? In your family and around you, what are some of the challenges you have faced in the last 1 year with your own learning and largely with also your life? So Kavya, maybe I'll invite you to go first.
Yes, sir. Thanks for choosing me first.
Yeah, sorry. And you can speak in English, Hindi or Kannada, and we can translate.
Okay, sir. It's okay. I'm fine with Hindi or English.
Go ahead, Kavya.
So, due to this pandemic last year, I was in 10th actually, 2020. I had my exams in March. March 15th was my exams. Due to this pandemic, they had postponed it. And we was like doing in online classes. Actually, portions were always always completed. And we were studying in home itself. And waiting for exams, when it will come and when we write the exam, when the burden will go from our head. It was waiting for that. And then there was some issue in our home. We had some financial issues, and at the same time, my father met with an accident and I lost him. So at the same time, in May, they announced that in June you will be having exams. So I was in some other thought that I lost my father, and one side I have to get distinction. I was actually 85% student, but in that situation I have written exam and I secured 70%.
Wow.
Actually it was okay for my family, but I was not satisfied, and it's okay for everyone, but it's not for me. It's not okay for me. I thought at least, okay, in first year at least I'll come up and get at least 90%, 95% and leave my family and make them proud. In first year also there was no exams for us. It was too tough to me to admit for college also. At college admission also was very tough. So I took Dream help and they offered me scholarship. And from that scholarship itself, I have joined for first year college in SJA in New Delhi. It was too tough going, and the first year, 1 month I have attended college. The other was a whole in online itself. Then now second year, first year they have passed like that only. We have done three tests. Based on that, they have given percentages, that's it. That percentages also are not much. My percentage was 65-70 itself. I couldn't get upgrade and I couldn't learn also in that situation. Now second PU has started, first chapters are completed. I'm trying my level best to get more marks and get good percentage to my family and make them proud. I'm trying more. And I have taken science field. I'm going in science field because I wanted to become a doctor. That was my father's dream that I should treat him, but I don't have the chance to do. So actually, so that I have not left that dream, I'm continuing. I have to write NEET next year, so I'm planning for better things. Also, it's very tough for us. It's tough going. We have, my mother stays in home. She is our housewife. My big sister, we are seeing matters for her, and second sister, she is actually working now. Don't know what happens. My sister is only making me to study now. I wanted to do part-time job and go for college, but my parents are not allowing me. They say you just study, you get percentage, but I don't want to see them in burden. But once said, I'm trying to get jobs and I'll try to do part-time job and make my own fees and pay my college fee, etc. So this is about myself. And because of pandemic, there is a lot of burden. Really, nothing has happened good. Everything is really bad for me in my life. Maybe for others it was a good time in home, and they enjoyed a lot which they couldn't enjoy before pandemic because of their busy schedules. But we had a nice gathering in home. We had nice time every time. In pandemic also, we used to have nice time. But after that incident, no, in our family, no one is smiling except me. I'm the joker in home who makes everyone laugh. I'm trying myself and trying more better to make them happy and keep them calm. That's it about myself, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Kavya. First, let me just acknowledge, I'm sorry to hear about your father. It must have been a very difficult situation for you and for your family. And I'm really glad that you're continuing with your dream that you had told your father to become a doctor, and trying to support your family through your smile and through your studies in this difficult time. And thank you for showing the courage to share this with all of us here today. Rukmini, did you want to add anything, or shall I go to Madhu?
Yes, go to next, Madhu.
No, I think we can maybe talk to Madhu.
Yeah, sure. So Madhu, we'd love to hear from you about what has been your experience of the last 1 year and more in school, in learning, in your life and family. You can share in English, Hindi or Kannada, whatever you're comfortable with. Thank you.
So my problem is my grandfather and grandmother is COVID-19. They go in hospital and come, and next day we came to my cousins, daddy, mommy, and cousins. They come, and another one problem is my sister take the percentage is 75 in SSLC. That problem. And my daddy is cried to my sister taken the percentage. So online class week also doing, and I did not understanding. I understanding, but
ನೀವು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿ ಮಧುಶ್ರೀ, ನಾನು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ಬೇಜಾರು. ಅಂದರೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಇವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಕ್ಕ 75% ತಗ್ಗಿದ್ದಾಳೆ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪ್ಪ ಹತ್ರು ಆದರೆ ನನಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಬೇಜಾರಾಯಿತು.
Thank you, Madhu. Madhu shared with us that her sister, who was giving a school leaving examination, got 75%, but her parents were not very happy with that, and her father was very sad that she didn't do well in education at this time. Madhu, do you want to talk a little bit about what challenges you faced with your own learning?
Shall I talk in Kannada?
Yes, Madhu. ನೀವು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡಲಿ, ನಾನು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಹಾಂ, ಅಂದರೆ ನನಗೆ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಇರೋದು ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಕ್ಕ ತೆಗೆದಿರೋ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ನಾನು ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ತೆಗಿತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಸರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ನೀನು ತೆಗಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಅದನ್ನ ಫೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಸೊ
ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೀ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನನಗೆ ಏನು ಇಷ್ಟ ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನಂದರೆ ಮನೆ ಕಟ್ಟಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಇಷ್ಟ. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಸ್ವಂತವಾದ ಮನೇನ ಕಟ್ಟಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಆಸೆ. ಮೈ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮಧು. ಮಧು ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಸ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್, there's pressure on her now to do well in examinations and get a better percentage. And second, she said her dream is that she wants to do well in life and build a home for her parents, and she hopes to do that. Thank you, Madhu, for sharing that. Muskan, can we come to you now? And could you share a bit about your own experience of the last 1 year?
So I appeared for my board exams when COVID was just beginning, and I was in the campus. And I remember we generally used to sit on all the benches, but then on the last exam we had to leave one bench and sit. And at that time I didn't really anticipate that the situation is going to be so gruesome. But then slowly and steadily we had to be under lockdown, and then it kept getting extended, and I had to wait for my 10th grade results, and I was planning on changing my school, so I couldn't really seek admission in any other school until I had my results. So I had to wait for around 4 to 5 months, and in that period not only me but my classmates and other children had no access to learning, and we had to suffer. We did not know when we'll have our classes. We did not know when we'll have our results. Finally, when the result came, I was able to get admission in another school. But then, since then, all my classes have been, virtually, and I've not really met my teachers in person for a very long time. And I've not been able to, develop that interaction that you usually have between a student and a teacher. And I generally feel, really alienated when I'm around my classmates, because all of them know each other, but I'm a new child and I have not been able to interact with them that much. So this situation has, come up with a lot of challenges, and then not only just academic challenges related with my education, but also, my father's salary was, not given, and we had to find a new job during COVID. So, which was a very, very challenging situation for all of us, because the economy and everything was so bad. And I think somewhere this entire isolation period has, you know, has resulted, on the positive side, it has been a good thing for me as an artist. I have developed, you know, better art skills. I have developed better writing skills because I was working on it constantly. But then I also saw, you know, like so many children around me were out of school and they migrated to their villages, and they, most of them are not even planning to come back and attend their schools. My mom is a tuition teacher. So she realized that the children who were able to read and write before the pandemic hit could not even recall basic alphabets. So that has been, you know, like very, very challenging for all of us in the family. Yes.
Thank you, Muskan, for giving us such a varied experience of the pandemic for you, with your learning, the school, examinations, relationships, family. Thank you for sharing that. I'm going to just check if Mahi is back. Yes, Mahi, can you hear us? Mahi, aap humko sun sakte hain?
Hello, sir.
Yes, Mahi. Sure. So, yes. So lovely to hear your voice, Mahi.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. So, Mahi is coming to us from Unnao in UP. Mahi, aap apna experience share karenge last ek saal ka. Kaisa raha aapka experience aapke family mein, learning mein?
Yes, sir. Sir, pehle lockdown, during lockdown, sir, thi, papa bhi aa gaye the, kyunki bahut family meri thi, ya kam, bahut ya karte the, unka वन माने की वजह से आ गए थे, तो उस लंका का लॉकडाउन होने जैसे वो भी घास में हम शायद अब दादा पापा के साथ रही पूरा बहुत बाद भी स्कूल ओपन मैं सेवेंथ में थी, थोड़े दिनों के लिए मेरे स्कूल जो वो ओपन हो गए थे एग्जाम से, ऐसे नहीं बस एग्जाम के लिए ओपन हुए थे, तो कन्वेंस ऐसे मैं कन्वेंस से जाती हूँ बट वो स्टूडेंट्स का पेरेंट्स नहीं भेजे थे, इस वजह से जो स्टूडेंट स्कूल होने की वजह से भेज रहे हैं उनके मैनेजर सर थे, उन्होंने बंद कर दिया, तो ऐसे कोई मेरा पर्सनल कन्वेंस में नहीं जा पाती थी, छोटी भी थी तो मम्मा डरती भी थी अकेले, इस वजह से मुझे दादी मेरी जो मेरी ग्रैंड मदर है वो मुझे रोज वहां ले जाती थी स्कूल जो कि काफी दूर है और धूप में, सो आई रियली ग्रैंड मदर काफी सो रियली थैंक फॉर माई जो कि सबसे ज्यादा वही वो मुझे लेने जाती थी और फिर वो में जाते उस टाइम में प्रॉब्लम स्टडी को लेकर फेस मुझे काफी हुई, मुझे चाहती हाँ अगर फैमिली मेरे लिए इतना कर रही है तो मुझे उनके लिए थैंक यू.
विशाल, वाइल माही का कनेक्शन अभी भी स्ट्रॉन्ग है तो मैं भी एक सवाल पूछ लेती हूँ बाय चांस अगर उनका कनेक्शन बाद में चला जाए कि माही सभी बच्चों ने ऑल द चिल्ड्रन दे स्पोक लॉट अबाउट पढ़ाई पढ़ाई के बारे में ज्यादा आप लोगों ने बोला है बट तुम मुझे बताओ कि तुम स्कूल के बारे में सबसे ज्यादा क्या मिस करती हो.
मैम मैं फ्रेंड्स को बहुत ज्यादा मिस करती हूँ और वो हमारा गेम पीरियड जिसे सबसे ज्यादा मिस करती हूँ मैं और टीचर्स.
तो गेम्स जो तुम लोग या फ्रेंड्स जो कह रही हूँ कि क्या तुम्हारे आसपास में भी घर के आसपास में भी तो फ्रेंड्स होंगे, क्या तुम्हारे स्कूल के फ्रेंड्स और घर के फ्रेंड्स अलग हैं कि उनके साथ जिस तरह से तुम स्कूल में चीजें कर सकती थी वैसे मोहल्ले में नहीं कर सकती हो?
यस मैम, बट मैम ये ड्यूरिंग कोविड बहुत कम हो गया था, सब स्कूल तो पूरी तरह से ऑफ था बट गांव में भी सब अब घर पे ही रहते थे, इस वजह से बहुत मिस करती थी मैं.
Vishal, shall I ask similar questions to Muskan? Again, same question, that there is a lot about school, which is beyond learning. So what do you miss most about school?
Most importantly, that personal connect I used to have with my teachers, and touch wood, I have received some great, you know, some of the greatest teachers, and I really, really want to develop a deeper understanding and deeper relationships with them. But then I've not been able to do so because everything has been virtual. So I wish that I can go back to school and then just, you know, be closer to my teachers.
Madhu, what about you?
Mom, can you tell the questions, Mom?
What do you miss most about school?
I miss the school because my greater teachers was understanding me to lesson, the read to lesson, and my alphabets also written teachers only. Because I'm missing the teachers, friends, the blackboard, and marker, pen, chalkies. I'm missing all. My friends also I'm missing.
And Kavya, you have moved from school to college in this time. So supposing somebody said that you can go back and you think about, because college life and school life can be different. So what do you think, if you are, when you think back about school, what is the thing that in the last 1 year you have missed the most?
What I have missed is my friends, what all problems they will have. They used to come and see me and I used to solve all those. I miss that, and I was a leader in my class, discipline leader. And I miss my band group. I used to play flute on Independence Days. Now I'm continuing it, but on Independence Day I used to stand in the first row and play front of me flag, that pride and all. I miss it very much. In 10th it was my last band. 3 years I have played band and I miss it a lot. My teachers who used to support me a lot and who used to guide me to go in this way, that way, I miss them a lot. But now I can't have that conversation with my teachers because they are busy with their students, with their new students. So I can't disturb them, but I'm in touch with my teachers. That I'm planning for Teacher's Day to go and cut the cake with them and celebrate their Teacher's Day happily. In 10th, when my batch was there, actually the question paper was changed. From 5 years, the pattern was same. And recently when my batch was there, the question paper was totally changed for 10th standard. So teachers didn't allow us for any celebration. We were just studying for the whole year. So Teacher's Day celebration also we were not doing. Actually in our school, every Teacher's Day used to celebrate by the 10th group because they will be the last batch of the school. So we didn't get the chance to do. So I'm requesting my principal ma'am to please allow me with my all 10th batch to celebrate Teacher's Day this year. I am asking her, but no reply from her still now, but I'm trying my best to do. So I miss all of that.
Very good idea. I think that I think this is something that we should tell everyone, that Teacher's Day should be celebrated whether school is open or not, because all students want to meet their teachers again, and also to do the kinds of things that you feel that you missed out because of the schools being closed at that point last time. Yeah. Vishal?
Thank you, Rukmini. So let's change track a little bit now, and let's talk into what are your hopes and what do you want changed, or what do you want from the time when school and colleges reopen? How do you want to now go back to your school and college? And what are your hopes for it? So Muskan, maybe I'll start with you.
Yes, so one thing that I think everybody has learned during, you know, these challenging times. I remember when we used to have computer classes, very few children were aware of the skills. And I think when, you know, schools closed down and when everyone had to shift to virtual medium, even teachers were suffering to, you know, adapt to this new medium. So I think when we go back to school now, we focus on developing these necessary skills that are required. So, you know, like being comfortable with technology and then having good communication skills so that even when, you know, that even when there's a crisis, students can easily adapt to it. And I think when I go back to school, I have like a lot of hopes from it. I hope that, you know, I have some opportunities to interact with my classmates, participate in opportunities, participate in inter-school competitions that I've not been able to do because of, you know, the situation. Yeah, so all that, I believe that we need to start working on that.
Thank you, Muskan. Rukmini, you wanted to say something?
Yeah, I wanted to, no, you go on. I have a question, but I'll ask after this round is done.
Okay, sure. So Kavya, I'll come to you now. I know you've had college open and close again. So what are your hopes when college reopens? What are your expectations from college?
I have expectation is to get good teaching and I have to learn good. And after starting college, also pandemic, this COVID will be like this itself. But we have to keep take precautionaries and stay far, wear mask and use sanitizer regularly. So if this is there, everything is good. No infections, nothing, no COVID affection, everything. So beyond this, I need cultural activities, which I have not performed in my college. And all like farewells and precious day, farewell day, like this. And wanted to continue my education good and wanted to enjoy college life with my friends. That's it.
Thank you, Kavya. Yes, college life can be very memorable when we spend time making new friends and being with them. Madhu, can I ask you to share your own hopes for going back to school?
Sir. Shall I talk in Kannada, sir?
Yes, Madhu, neevu Kannada alli maatadli, na translate maatadli.
Iga eshto makkalige aagin class idre avargu artha agala inobobrige artha agutte andre naan helidu enandre iga online class kinta offline idre eshto best anta offline idre yakandre artha agala obrige inobrige artha agutte aa tara irutte. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆಫ್ಲೈನ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಈಗ ಡೌಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೇಳಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಆಫ್ಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಕರೆನ್ಸಿ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರ ಮನೇಲಿ. ಸೊ ನನ್ನ ಹೋಪ್ ಏನಂದರೆ ಈಗ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಬದಲು ಆಫ್ಲೈನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಓಕೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನನ್ನ ಹೋಪ್ ಏನಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಈಗ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೀಡರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೀಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಈಗ ಆ ಥರ ಆಗ ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ನಾನು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಜಾರು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನನ್ನ ಹೋಪ್ ಏನಂದರೆ ಈಗ ಸ್ಕೂಲಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫುಡ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ವಿನ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನನಗೆ ಆಸೆ ತುಂಬ. ಸೊ ನನ್ನ ಹೋಪ್ ಅದು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಫ್ಲ್ಯಾಗ್ ಹಾರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನನ್ನ ಆಸೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚಿಂಗ್, ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್, ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ. ಸೊ ನನ್ನ ಹೋಪ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಬೇಗ ಓದಬೇಕು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮಗೆ ಹೆಸರು ತಂದುಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನನ್ನ ಆಸೆ ಸರ್.
Thank you, Madhu. Madhu has said a lot of things. I may not remember all of them. She said that she prefers offline classes to online classes. Some people prefer online classes, but she prefers offline classes because then if she has any doubts, she can clarify right there. She can also hear better when it is offline. And sometimes there are internet issues. Sometimes I don't have currency to buy internet. So she hopes that the schools open and offline classes start soon. when school opens, she wants to participate in all the activities. She was a leader in her class. Right now, she's not the leader. But she was a leader in a class before. And she also used to love participating in activities, including singing, dancing, and giving speech on Independence Day. So she was looking forward to doing that again at the Independence Day. And her hope for her life is that she'll study well and she'll bring a good name to her parents. Mahi, आप अपने होप्स आशाएं बता सकते हैं कि जब स्कूल खुलेगा आपकी क्या आशाएं?
यस सर।
माही आपकी आवाज सुनाई नहीं दे रही है।
हेलो सर।
हाँ अभी सुनाई दे रही है प्लीज। हाँ बोलिए।
सर फर्स्टली स्कूल जब मेरे रीओपन होंगे तो मैं जितने भी मेरे फ्रेंड्स टीचर्स जिनको मैं बहुत ज्यादा मिस कर रही थी मैं उनसे मिलूंगी और मेरी स्टडी जो कुछ भी मुझे समझ ऐसे ऑनलाइन का तो एक टाइम शेड्यूल होता था कि हाँ जो इतने से इतने तक चलेगी जिसमें बाद में अगर मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम भी हो जाती थी तो टीचर्स नहीं होते थे सामने तो मैं कंफर्म नहीं कर पाती थी मुझे डाउट बहुत सारे रहते थे। अभी जब मेरे स्कूल ओपन हो जाएंगे तो अगर मुझे कुछ नहीं समझ में आएगा तो मेरे टीचर्स होंगे फ्रेंड्स होंगे जिनसे डिस्कशन करके कंफर्म करके मेरे सारे डाउट जो है वो खत्म हो जाएंगे जो कि स्टडी करते टाइम मुझे बहुत सारे डाउट आते हैं जिनमें फ्रेंड्स की ज़रूरत और टीचर्स की होती है। ऑनलाइन क्लासेस में बहुत सारे इशू थे बट अभी जब ऑफलाइन क्लासेस मेरी स्टार्ट हो जाएंगी तो और जो भी स्कूल फंक्शंस होते थे मैं बहुत पार्टिसिपेट करती थी मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता था मैं वो भी बहुत मिस करती थी। अभी मुझे बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है कि सारे फंक्शंस जो होंगे मैं पार्टिसिपेट करूँगी ऑल टाइप फंक्शंस आई विल ज्वाइन एंड बहुत ज़्यादा इंजॉय करूँगी अपने फ्रेंड्स से और टीचर्स से जिन्हें भी मैं मिस करती थी सो बहुत अच्छा लगेगा मुझे।
थैंक यू वेरी मच फाइन सच अ ब्यूटीफुल शेयरिंग। रुक्मिणी आई थिंक वी हैव अबाउट 6 मिनट्स सो यू कैन आस्क योर क्वेश्चन एंड वी कैन
या सो व्हाट आई वांटेड टू आस्क इज इफ यू सी न्यूज़पेपर ऑन टीवी हर जगह पे देयर इज बिग कंट्रोवर्सी शुड स्कूल्स ओपन शुड दे नॉट ओपन So I want aap sabka from each of you your vote. Do you want schools to open right now? Yes or no? And if you want to add just one line about why you want schools to open right now, then you say it. But time is short, so bahut brief. Okay, starting with Mahi. You want schools to open? Yes or no? And one short answer, why?
Yes, of course, why? Of course, yes.
Okay. And one reason why, main reason why.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, ma'am.
My ek reason why tum keh rahe ho ki school khule, bahut short mein.
Ma'am, mujhe apne sare teachers aur sare friends se milna hai.
Okay, very good. Madhu, what about you? You want school to open, yes or no, and one line, why?
Ma'am? Ma'am, I can't hear you, ma'am.
I'm saying, say if you want school to open right now, yes or no, and whatever you say, give me one line answer why you're saying that.
Because offline is best because kids are have doubt to answer that and teachers teachers want salary to
Okay, Muskan?
Definitely yes, because if we don't open now then it will take us a lot of time to bridge the learning gap.
Wonderful. Kavya?
Of course, yes, ma'am.
understand better and enjoy my college life also.
Fantastic, fantastic. Great to hear from all of you, and let us all hope that schools open quickly. We can meet our friends, our teachers, and do all the things that school is all about. Vishal, Shweta, I know we have very, very little time.
So Rukmini, maybe you could start off with just a summary of reflections that you have had of listening to the young people. Then I'll probably do myself, and Shweta can close it with her own reflections.
Sure. I think, thank you so much, sabhi bachchon ko, all of you, for sharing and sharing in detail. I think there has been a lot of difficulties, both as a result of what happened at home and also being off online, as Madhu was saying, that we are all used to being in a face-to-face with our friends, with our teachers, and with our studies. And so it has been a very difficult time. But I also hear in everybody's voice, even though sometimes you didn't say it, that you've learned a lot in this time. You've learned a lot how to deal. The way, Kavya, you are so brave. You spoke about the things that your family had to go through after your father. I think, Madhu, you were talking about how your sister had to go through difficult exam, and then parents were not as happy as perhaps they would have been. Muskan, shifting schools. From Mahi, about Mahi ki grandmother ka role kitna important raha taki wo school ja paaye. So I think ki in many ways you have gone through a very difficult time, but you are still smiling. I can see all of you smiling. You have learned. You have learned how to help each other. Many of you spoke of other people, not just of yourself. And I think in many ways also, probably hamare families mein logon ne bhi kis tarike se is situation ko deal karna hai. Like Kavya, how your family is saying, don't work part-time, you need to study. So I think that in different ways, I think in our own way, we have learned how to cope. My one big reflection is that I want schools to open everywhere so that jis tarah ka discussion hamara yahan ho raha hai, school mein ho paaye, and that teachers and friends and students together can decide ki agar fir se kisi wajah se school band ho jaye, if the school closes again for some reason, how we are going to plan, because we didn't get time to plan when all this happened last time. So my takeaway is that everybody, children, teachers, parents, have learned a lot. We need to put those learnings together. As I think Kavya said, COVID is still here. It has not gone away. And like a switch, it may go on and off. But like we do at home, when the switch goes on and off, we have candle, we have lantern, we have many other things, so that we need a little time for preparation. That is my takeaway. And I loved listening to all of you. I wish time was not so short.
Thank you, Rukmini. I also want to thank Muskan, Madhu, Kavya, and Mahi for joining us and sharing your thoughts with us and opinions with us. I have three reflections. One is a recognition and understanding that even through the school closures, life has happened for all of us and for these young people. There have been massive life changes with death and loss and grief, change of schools. And it's important for us to recognize that life is happening for these young people, and we need to create spaces to help young people make meaning of these big life changes and big life transitions. What I heard from all the young people is that school goes beyond just a place where you go to gain knowledge and read, write, and do mathematics and sciences. There are relationships, there are connectionships, there's relationships with teachers, with friends, there are activities that one participates in. So school has its own life ecosystem, which children are missing out on. And third, I think, in the first part when Mahi was trying to share and her voice was not coming out fully, for me, this is also reflective of how young people's voices are invisible, and they continue to be invisible even in spaces like this. And beyond just listening to these young people, we also need to bring them and make them part of the decision-making process. If four young people in this call are saying they want schools to open for a variety of reasons, it's time we really listen to them. Thank you again very much. Over to you, Shweta.
Thank you. Sabse pehle Muskan, Madhu, Kavya, and Mahi, thank you so much. Thank you for joining and thank you for sharing very openly and honestly. I think adults are finding it hard to share what they have lived through in COVID. And you've set a great example, how openly you're sharing your stories of struggle, but most importantly, how you've adapted and the resilience you've shown. So I think thank you for teaching all of us and all, everyone who's hearing us today that lesson. I think second, it's Rukmini and Vishal, I was so overwhelmed with all the examples the children gave, right? We spoke about alphabet recognition, doubt clarification, cultural activities, friends, teacher. We even spoke about a blackboard. But the children are actually missing everything, right? The people aspect, the learning aspect, the social aspect, even the physical space. And I think that for me has come out so clearly that children want to go back to school. And I think Kavya, thank you for also being very mature to say that we have to learn to change our behavior. We have to wear our mask. We have to use the sanitizer. I will add, we have to get vaccinated. But then life has to go on and we have to learn to live with this. But get back to school, get back to learning, get back to a solution that works for all of us. Thank you once again. And Rukmini and Vishal, thank you for genuinely being the best panelists in a session where we have the children voices. Much appreciated. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.